Hello and welcome to my second course, which is micro-credential digital seismic pre-processing. So in this course, we are going to learn about the pre-processing of the seismic data. We are not going into the details of doing NMO correction, static correction, velocity analysis, or migration. But what we are focusing, we will be focusing on certain topics which will be including but not limited to. So in this course, we will be having six videos. So the first video is digital seismic recording system, in which I'm going to show how the seismic recording system work and what are the things inside this recording system. Then we will be moving to the demultiplexing and reformatting of the data. So once it is acquired in the field, how does it look like? It looks like a time slice, but then for initial processing, we have to convert into demultiplex format. So overview of that topic we are going to discuss in the second video. And this third lecture or the third video will be focusing on muting and trace editing and absorption as well. So if you are encounter some bad geophone or there was a dead trace because of some abnormal receivers, so that remove you can affect in that task. Then the second module of this lecture or this course is the seismic filters and their type. So in that we will be focusing on low pass, high cut, low high pass, low cut, and band pass filter and notch filter as well. Then we will be moving to look at the marine seismic acquisition and processing of marine data. Over there, there is a large effect of seismic multiples, and FK autonomy will look into how we can remove the seismic multiples, and also we'll look what are the possible method to look to remove these seismic multiples. So in the last but not least, the lecture will be focusing on improving the seismic signals, because once you record into the field, so because of Q attenuation, so that is the effect you have the low amplitude at the below trace. If you go deeper, your signal will be weaker and weaker. So there are some seismic gains such as AGC, PGC. So these type of gain we will discuss and how these gains can improve the seismic signals to do the further processing. So with that's all. Thank you so much. And I hope you will enjoy this course, and in the end of this course you will be having an assessment. So each module have one quiz as well as the second module another quiz. So once you complete this course, you will be having the certification for this course as well. And welcome to everyone for joining this course. All the description about the course is in the description box, so you can follow the course by looking at the description. Thank you so much and welcome back again.